With the rise in the spread of coronavirus globally and the virus being declared a global pandemic, countries have since felt the impact on its health sector. The Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry held a forum on the impact of the virus.
During the forum by the Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the special guest spoke on some of the sectors which would not be heavily affected by the coronavirus outbreak in Nigeria.
We think that the crisis has given rise to both challenges and opportunities, because just as people are taking a hammering on the stock exchange, which is currently on a bearish run, we are now seeing that some people are also using the opportunity to actually take positions where they would ordinarily not have invested, been able to invest because of high market prices. So we're also seeing that companies that have staged their production and supply chains by use of technology and by use of modern trading platforms such as B2B exchanges and B2C exchanges are better able to counteract the impact of this virus on their sales volumes. Online traders, they have seen this crisis as a direct positive impact on their sales volume. So it's not been all negative for everybody. Also, companies that have invested in digitalization, automation, and use of AI have also been able to, in a sense, shield themselves from the most damaging impact of production shutdowns, because obviously machines do not suffer contagion, at least not of viruses such as the COVID-19.
Furthermore, he emphasized on the measures taken by the private sector to prevent the spread of the virus, as well as the impact on the virus on manufacturing sector, amongst others.
And I think a lot of corporates are also looking internally at their protocols, enforcing more policies around cleanliness, people sanitizing their hands before coming into the workspace, things about what to do if you have symptoms, fever, and so on. And I think corporates will continue to undertake such measures in order to be able to provide comfort to their workers that they can work in a safe environment. No, Nigeria is not an island on its own. A lot of corporates have supply chains that run through the Far East and China, and we know that China has suffered a slowdown on account of this crisis. So a lot of our manufacturing input comes through the Far East. So obviously, if those supply chains are disrupted, there will be a direct impact on manufacturing capacity in Nigeria.
For Plus TV Africa, Irene Ubani.